Rightio, it is coming to that favourite time of the year. The weebs version of the gamers version of E3 being Jump Festa, the happiest time of the year. Because who cares about Christmas when we have Jump Festa? Am I right? And with Jump Festa, we have a Bleach Super Stage. So, stick around while we discuss what can and can't be. So if you were there for last year, it was the first time that we get to see a Bleach Super Stage in like absolutely years. For some people, for the first time. And while last year was a monumental moment because it was the first time we get to actually finally speak about a Bleach anime in 2021 and getting not only some talks about the voice actors, but also the trailer itself, which again, probably saved Jump Festa as the really, to me anyway, wasn't that many great announcements. I mean, sure, we had a Chainsaw Man stage as well, but that was literally a 30 to 40 minute interview, which was very disappointing. Now, this is the first time we're going to be getting a Jump Festa Super Stage with the Bleach anime actually airing. So it's very difficult to kind of talk about what to expect because we have to look at other shows that have animes as well as Jump Festa Super Stages. And really, the most consistent one is usually One Piece, which they do a grand bravado kind of, they do all sorts of things, but that's One Piece and it's a bit of an outlier. So the point of this video is, let's really just discuss what we believe is going to maybe what we wish to happen, and let's talk about the actual things that are realistic to happen, if that makes sense. So, I of course asked Twitter what they would like to see and what they would like me to talk about, and there is four major things that we can discuss in this. One, talk about a potential trailer. Two, a possible Hell Arc confirmation. Three, Burn the Witch. And the fourth, a console game. Let's talk about the first and foremost one, about the Bleach second core, because by this time we would be in about episode 6 to 7 when Jump Festa is actually happening, which will be about half the time that we're into the first core. So we will probably get a lot of information in regarding to maybe when the second core will start or whether it's going to continue from the first one, because that is a possibility. Though I really highly doubt it, you have to still discuss about it just in case. Now, I would say that this is more of the more plausible thing to happen in Jump Festa, getting a second core information as well as a potential key visual, which I believe is probably going to be the Everything But the Rain arc, considering the information that we know so far. So it's possible we're going to get a key visual in regarding potentially Misaki and Isshin and Ryuken, maybe even Urahara and White, we don't really know. But again, that would be a really nice key visual to have. And of course, chances are we're probably going to have a lot of voice actors talking about their experiences with the Bleach anime, probably some favorite scenes from the new one and maybe the old one, because again, you know, they like to really waste time on, not saying that voice actors, like, you know, are a waste of time, but they like to pad out a lot of time on voice actor commentary. So do I think we're going to get a teaser for a second core in regards to an actual video format? I don't think so. I don't think we're going to get a trailer or anything like that. If anything, at the most, we're probably going to get a key visual, being what I just mentioned for Everything But the Rain. The second most requested one to talk about is the Hell chapters, or the continuation of the Hell arc. And while I don't believe personally that this will be really discussed or really announced in any way, shape or form, I do believe it will be mentioned, giving us a little bit of a hint towards something. So it will still be speculatory, but as I said, we had the voice actor of Ichigo being Morita, and one of the editors in the last Jump Festa Expo that we had kind of discussed a little bit about the Hell chapter and about how they both want to see more of that content. So hopefully there's a little bit of a slip up with either Nakano or maybe Kubo's editor or whoever else is involved around Kubo that can potentially give us a smidgen more about that, because as Kubo's already said, he will stop, you know, drawing it once he stops getting asked to. So I mean, that's still a good sign. I did a whole video about it, so go make sure to check that out. The link of course will be in the description. Let's talk about Burn the Witch, because Burn the Witch is also an interesting one to talk about. Now of course this isn't going to be a Burn the Witch stage, so to say, but I would imagine that will also get spoken about to some degree as well. And the reason why I say this is because if you are a member of Club Outside, when Bleach had its first anniversary for that website in particular, everyone gets a newsletter or an email. And as you can see on screen, one of these emails did say that there would be Burn the Witch news this year, or even some announcements to some degree. To which, if you've been in this year so far, there have been zero Burn the Witch announcements. And the only possible context is potentially towards the end of the year being Jump Festa. So will we get Burn the Witch news around about that time? I think it's heavily plausible, and I really wouldn't scratch it off the bingo card. However, I will say, because Kubo's been involved in so much in terms of the anime and production and getting his hands on the marketing and all that sort of stuff, he's been really full hands on, especially with Club Outside as well, as well as many other things in terms of like figure designs and approvals for all that sort of stuff, as well as K-Lab's Bleach Brave Souls and their designs for new characters. Do I think that Kubo is in any way, shape or form ready to drop more Burn the Witch? Maybe not yet, but I do believe there will be some kind of announcement in regards to giving us more next year. It could be late next year for all we know, but any kind of confirmation or any kind of news in regards to what's happening with that would be amazing as well. And I would imagine that Shueisha probably want Burn the Witch back in their magazine as soon as possible. So again, I do believe that Burn the Witch will probably have some kind of talk or announcement in regards to it, because again, unless something's changed, it seems that they did have plans for Burn the Witch, considering they dropped it within this newsletter. So there was something, or still is something. So again, I still find it highly plausible. And I guess the last one to really talk about is a console game. And while I do believe there is one in the works, because I've heard talks, but I haven't really elaborated more on it, because again, I don't really get involved into the gaming scene all that much, I have to kind of be the bearer of bad news and say console games, especially with anime games, aren't really a common occurrence to have announcements. Sure, Jump Fest are always show console games at their exhibit. However, when it comes to announcing console games, it is usually very unlikely. These are some things that you usually get at like your E3s or even your Tokyo game shows, or even sometimes they just independently announce these things, maybe for an anniversary. But I don't believe, from my recollection, that many, if at all, game announcements come from Jump Festa, unless it's like in V Jump or something. I'm not quite sure, but I don't think there'll be a Bleach game announcement. Though I will like to say that I hope that I'm wrong, because I would love to see a Bleach game announcement, but I'm not really going to be hyping you guys up for the potential of it, neither will I hype myself up about it either. So when it comes to that kind of concept, I don't see it happening. But if you guys believe it, then I'm all for you and I'm rooting for you on that one too. So I'm really excited. I think it's going to be a really interesting time, and it's going to be a different experience to see what Bleach has to offer at a Jump Festa for the first time, with an anime going during a Jump Festa of all things as well. So my overall predictions on what I think is going to happen is that they're probably going to show one of the trailers, which is the one that we've probably just seen, maybe with maybe a few more extra clips at the start of the Bleach panel itself. They're going to start that. They're going to introduce all the voice actors. They're going to talk about the anime for a little bit. And then on the second half, they're likely going to talk about the second call and what they're excited to see. And hey, they may even give us more information on the added scenes and maybe more of what they plan to do later on. But they'll definitely talk about what the reception has been to Bleach in those 6 to 7 episodes. So it's going to be really cool to see the perspective of the Japanese audience as well, and how they've received it, as well as us, because you can really garner popularity based off their impressions and, you know, Shueisha's own like chief and editor, and also Kubo's editor himself. So it's really going to be interesting to see where going forward Bleach is going to be moving. I think Bleach is going to have many more collabs and many more special things and merchandise along the way, and we're probably going to get a ton of new figures from the Bandai booth as well. So really look forward to that, because that's usually where they showcase like prototypes and whatnot as well. But I think again, it's going to be most likely voice actor talks with some anime clips that they really liked, and then following up talking about some stuff towards the end. So that's kind of my predictions. I know it's pretty much of a nothing burger video, but hey, at least it gets you guys talking and gives you kind of a little bit of an expectation on what to see. But again, it's always fun to just live stream with you guys, talk about it and just view it and experience it together. So I'm definitely excited for that. And because it is on a late night stream, chances are it's definitely going to be live streamed on YouTube somewhere. So we're going to get to experience it. And it's overall just a fun time. So yeah, I'm going to leave it off with that. Tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. And as always, people, you guys, of course, have this fine day. Be enhanced. Peace out.